If you're using Ableton Live for click and tracks on stage, it's really important to make sure you separate both of those. Hey, I'm Will Doggett, Ableton Live certified trainer, founder of From Studio to Stage. Today, I'm gonna show you how you can separate your click from your tracks. This makes it essential if you're gonna be using Ableton Live on stage for tracks. So let's get started. All right, so this is very easy to do. Let me quickly take you through how to make this happen. So if you're using Live's built-in metronome, a few things you need to know. One, we can turn the metronome on and off here just by clicking on these two buttons. And once it's lit up yellow, that means that Live's metronome is on. Now, if we want to adjust the volume of Live's metronome, we can go over here to the cue out volume. Now, Live's metronome is routed through the cue out. And so we adjust that level and that's going to adjust our metronome. So if I press play, you can hear the level of the click or the metronome change as I do that. Now, remember, if you're in Live 10, a few extra things you get when you work with the metronome. So I click this arrow, we can choose a different click sound. So we can go from classic to click, which sounds like this, to wood, which is gonna give us more of a wood block sound, which sounds like that. And the other thing we can do is we can choose a subdivision. So I can select eighth notes, and now my click sounds like this. And that's gonna help your band stay a little more in sync and a little more in time when using the metronome. So let's talk about how to route this separate from my tracks. In this scenario, in this track, I am just using Live's metronome. So I need to do two things. One, I'm gonna go to cue out here and I wanna make sure my metronome is set to one. And then all my tracks are routed to master. So you can see here, all the audio two for all my tracks is set to master. So I'm gonna go to master out and select two. So what this does is it's gonna split click down the left side and tracks out of the right side. Now, depending on what audio interface you're using or if you're just using the built-in headphone out of your laptop, then you're gonna wanna plug that in and choose what of those two outs that you're using. If you're using more than those outs, maybe you have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with the interface, you still wanna make sure click is on one isolated by itself or maybe combined with guide, but we wanna split that. Now, the cool thing about doing this is when we sum all our tracks to two by selecting two, we don't lose one side or the other. We're not just selecting the right side of our tracks. Ableton is gonna automatically sum all those tracks to where we get a mono signal, summed mono signal out of the second output, which is really, really cool. Now, let's say I'm in a situation like this where I need to then take these stems, render them out to use them in a live scenario, or I wanna use my own click sound. How do we do that in Ableton Live? Super easy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to instruments and drag in a drum rack. So what I'm gonna basically create is a MIDI clip with my own custom drum sounds. For this, I just wanna find a few sounds. So let's go to drums here and I'm gonna just search for wood. Okay, so there's some drum hits. We have different sounds here. So let's do miscellaneous percussion and we have wood percussion. Okay, I don't really like that one. Let's go to wood here, wood block. Okay, perfect, wood block high and low. So what I'm gonna do is use the low one as my default quarter note. All right, and I'm gonna drop that right on C1 and the high one as my accent. Okay, so what I wanna do is just create a MIDI clip. So I'm gonna select a measure. I'm gonna do Command Shift M to create my MIDI clip that's a measure long. Then I'm just gonna program a click. This song's in 4/4, so it's super easy. So I'm gonna double click on beat one using, again, the low sound. This is gonna represent the basic quarter note. And then I'm gonna add beats 2, 3, and then 4. Okay, and then on beat one with the accent, I'm gonna actually add high, and then I'll remove my other clip here. If you don't want the accent, then you don't have to do that. I'm gonna turn off Live's metronome. This clip is set to loop, so I'm gonna drag it the entire length of the song. Okay, and then we're gonna get here and we're gonna rename this click. And then I just like for the click to be the very first track in my song, so we'll move this up. And now when we press play, we hear our new click, which is awesome. Again, you could change the click sound to be whatever you want it to be. You could create multiple MIDI clips that represent different time signatures and save those in a live set and reference them again. But this is a big, big help if you are creating your own tracks and need to render out a click to then drop those stems back into another live set. So if you want more tricks and tips of how to speed up your usage of Ableton Live on stage, kind of best practices, then make sure to head to fromstudiotostage.com where you can start a free 7-day trial, get access to every single course in the catalog, join our private Facebook community where you can interface with other people looking to use Ableton Live on stage. And then finally, you get access to a private call each month with just the subscribers where we talk about issues we're having with Ableton Live, Live, things we learned, and then I'll also share some things that I learned that week with Ableton Live. I think you'll really enjoy it. So thanks so much for watching this tutorial. Hope to see you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.